President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. back in Cebu, bringing with him a slew of projects for one of the provinces that helped him pull off a massive victory in the 2022 polls. Her very own Katrina Domingo now joins us with an update. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. President Ferdinand Marcos's trip to Cebu this morning or today served as a sort of victory homecoming for the president, as this is the first time that he actually flew back to the Philippines' most vote-rich province since he won the presidency back in May last year. Carmina, we recall Cebu gave him 1 million votes, which helped catapult him to the highest elected position of the land, which is why across the speeches of the president in different events here in Cebu, he consistently thanked Cebuano for their support, for helping him, as he mentioned, pull off a massive victory last year. Let's take a listen to what the president had to say to Cebuanos.
Ito na ang pinakauna kong pagkakataon na magpasalamat sa lahat ng Cebuano sa inyong tulong, sa inyong suporta na ibinigay sa amin sa nakaraang halalan kami ni Inday Sara. At tama yung sinasabi ni Gov Gwen, totoo nga, it was history making, and you were part of that history. For that, I will always be grateful for the rest of my life.
Carmina, Cebu Governor Gwendolyn Garcia noted that the president really knows how to express his gratitude towards Cebuanos because he brought with him, as mentioned earlier, a slew of projects which will benefit this major city in Visayas. Among these projects is the launching of the Kadiwa ng Pangulo, which is a community bazaar wherein products from micro, small, and medium enterprises are sold at cheaper prices. He also attended the groundbreaking ceremony of the Cebu Bus Rapid Transit System, which is expected to help improve Cebu's mass transportation system, as several bus lines will be connected to the Cebu port, which in turn is expected to make the commuters' lives here more efficient and more easy compared to what they are experiencing today. And just right now, Carmina, a few minutes ago, the president just left this area in Cebu City, where he attended the groundbreaking ceremony of a housing project here. In his speech here, Carmina, he promised that his administration's goal of building 1 million housing units every year will not be impossible. Add to that the statement of House Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez, who was also here earlier. He says that the Congress is continuously finding ways to ensure that there will be sufficient funding for the government to achieve its goal of building a total of 6 million housing units by the end of President Marcos Jr.'s term. Carmina, later today, the president is expected to travel to Mandaue City, where he will give out several ayudas or aid packages, relief packages to Cebuanos, to indigent Cebuanos there. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Our very own Katrina Domingo there joining us live from Cebu. Thanks, Kat. Some 118 senior police officials who submitted courtesy resignations have already been screened by the panel, tasked to review their possible involvement in illegal drugs. The PNP maintains the five-man committee is making sure the review process is thorough. 800 more police officials are set to undergo the evaluation process.
Isisikapin po nila na makapag-meeting po ng at least twice a week para mas maging mabilis po yung magiging proseso at evaluation po ng ating mga senior officers po ng PNP. Ang target date po nila ay ayaw na nilang paabutin ng 3 months po talaga, although yun po yung tinitignan nila nung una na more or less mga around 3 months. But they are targeting po na sana matapos po within 2 months po to. Subalit ayaw rin naman po nilang masyadong madaliin dahil makompromise din naman po at mabaliwala yung naging pagsusumiti po na basta na lamang po basahin yung mga dokumento at mga dumadating po sa kanilang mga report.
Initial results of the review will be sent to the National Police Commission.
Ang National Police Commission naman ang magre-review nito at titignan. Hindi na niya pwedeng dagdagan yung listahan. From there, titignan, nireviewin maigi kung sino talagang tatanggapin ang resignation.
Last month, Philippine Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos asked top police officials to submit courtesy resignations in a bid to cleanse the force of so-called narco cops.